Right now we are at Windmill Line Co-operative. We are in the St. Lawrence Market community in downtown Toronto.
Oh, the Windmill Line community is great. I've been living here for 11 years.
The community at Windmill Line is a vibrant community. It's diverse. We have pioneers of the co-op movement that have lived here for 40 years. In 2019, the membership passed an environmental sustainability policy and essentially kickstarted a process for us to review our waste reduction practices. The policy itself was a recognition of the need for more sustainable practices in our community. When we contacted the Toronto Environmental Alliance, or T, they introduced us to the Zero Waste High-Rise project. The co-op has undertaken several environmental initiatives since starting their work with T. We have done a cooking oil collection drum. We have reorganized our recycling room. The biggest one that we have done now has been our chute conversion to organics. Before we had one garbage chute, and now we've made a conversion to organics. Really seeing those hands come up saying, yes, let's do a chute conversion. For me, what's really the most exciting moment, we've reduced our amount of garbage waste to one bin per week. We're trying to get to one bin per month. Volunteer members of the organization, they came together and they organized practices for waste reduction. The cooperative as a model itself, instead of just sort of implementing practices from above, we're implementing practices collectively.
The core values of sustainability, participation, sharing, having a voice, because each member has a vote.
The zero waste team of the building really did a good job in sending the proper messaging. They put big banners in the lobbies explaining the process. And I think most importantly, they started the zero waste newsletter. They even adopted a mascot. It's a small little green alien. It really caught people's attention. The little alien was getting the message across. Flatten your boxes, throw your batteries in the correct place. LED bulbs go here, pens, calculators, anything. Electronics go in this place. The level of environmental consciousness has really developed amongst the community collectively.
Because I'm so involved, especially with the Zero Waste team, every day I see what the benefits are to living in a co-op.
I think at this point we can acknowledge and recognize the membership of Windmill Line as being a membership that really wants and is really engaging with sustainable practice.
I've found out that once we get people involved in especially the projects that Zero Waste team has put into place, this camaraderie and the support we get and the encouragement we get is just unbelievable. What would I say to other co-ops? I would say, go for it. You not only are working towards environmental sustainability, but while you're doing it, you're building a community, you're reducing your costs, you're making members aware of the wider world and how the efforts you make within your building can benefit so much more than just yourselves.
Other co-ops that want to become more sustainable, they really need to engage with their membership. They need to engage with their board. Really talk to other co-ops or talk to the federations in the sector to see if you can implement an environmental sustainability policy. Contact local organizations, environmental organizations, and ask them what kind of initiatives they could recommend or they even work with the co-op. I think that at the very core of cooperative housing, there's always been a recognition and an understanding that the environment that we live in is probably one of the most important things.